न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 5 मल्टीपल्स एंड फैक्टर्स ओके ऑल ऑफ यू ओपन योर मैथ्स टेक्स्ट बुक एंड कम टू पेज नंबर 86 ओके देयर यू विल हैव दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर सो द चैप्टर नेम इज मल्टीपल्स एंड फैक्टर्स सो दिस चैप्टर इंक्लूड्स टू डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स दैट इज मल्टीपल्स एंड फैक्टर्स फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल लर्न अबाउट मल्टीपल्स ओके नाउ सो इन द फर्स्ट पेज दे हैव गिवन Warm up. Samira and her friends collected candies on Halloween day. Complete the given day. Halloween day. Halloween day means winter days. Okay. Halloween day is nothing but winter days. Here, Samira and her friends collected candies. Candies means chocolates and things. Oh, candies with you. On Halloween day, complete the given table. Okay. And here they have given 5 × 5, 10, 15 are products of 5. Okay. Now we are children and candy. So here we are having one table. One for one student. Sorry, for one child, 5 candies are there. For 2, 10 candies are there. For 3, 15. I have completed this particular table. For 4, 20. For 5 student, children, 25 candies will be required. And for 6 children, 30 candies will be required. Okay. Now Samira has separated the different types of candies. See and write the multiplication fact for each. Okay. Samira and her friends collected so many different kinds of candies. So later what Samira did is she separated different kinds of chocolates. Okay. You have lots of chocolates. Parle ji, kacha mango, melody, okay. And alpengibe. You have lots of candies. But you can collect them and mix up. But later in the separate. Brand wise separate madadru yaru Samira ivage enu antara avu enu antaru illi nodu first picture alaga so we are having some 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 lollipops so the sentence what they have given it is dash group of dash lollies or 6 is equal to 1 into 6 it is dash group of means one group of 6 lollies okay group is 1 okay And in that group, how many lollies are there? Lollipops are there? 6. So, or you can write this statement numerically as 6 is equal to 1 into 6. Okay. In the same way, here we are having two groups. Okay. So, two groups you can see here. So, let us read the sentence. These are dash groups. These are two groups of how many candies? Okay. Each group has how many candies? 3 candies. Okay. So here we are having total 2 groups and in each group how many candies are there? 3 candies. So right here 3. These are 2 groups of 3 candies. This is the statement or you can write this statement numerically as 6 is equal to 2 into 3. Here 2 indicates the number of groups and 3 indicates the number of candies in each group. Okay. In the same way here also we have how many groups? 3 groups. Okay. Each group has How many candies? 2 candies. Then these are 3 groups of 2 toffees or numerically you can write these statements as 6 is equal to 3 into 2. Here 3 indicates the number of groups and 2 indicates the number of chocolates in each group. Okay. Now multiples. Okay. So here one in this box they have given one sentence. Now let us read that. 1, 6, 2, and 3 can divide 6 completely with 0 as remainder. Okay. 1, 6, 2, and 3. Okay. I will write here. 1, 6, 2, and 3. So these numbers can divide 6 completely by keeping the remainder as 0. Okay. Now let us learn about multiples. What are multiples? Okay. So what is the term multiple? Okay. Now when we multiply different numbers such as 1, 2, 3 and so on by a number we get the product of that number. Okay. When we multiply different numbers such as 1, 2, 3 and so on by a number we get the product of that number. For example when we multiply 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 with 3 we get different product. Okay. Now let us multiply 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. We are having some 5 numbers. I will multiply all the
5 numbers by 3 only. Okay? 1 into 3, 2 into 3, 3 into 3, 4 into 3, 5 into 3. So 1 into 3 is 3. 2 into 3 is 6. 3 into 3 is 9. 4 into 3 is 12. 5 into 3 is 15. Okay. 3, 6, 9, 15. Sorry, 12 and 15. So these are all are called as the what? Called as the multiples of 3. Okay, this is 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 are called multiples of this number 3. Okay, so I will write here. So these are all multiples of 3. Okay, now similarly, if we multiply 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 with 7, we get multiples of 7. Okay, now let us multiply 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 by 7. Okay, as we have multiplied with 3 row in the same way, now I will multiply 1, 2, 3, and 4 and 5 by 7. Okay, 1 into 7, 2 into 7, 3 into 7, 4 into 7, 5 into 7. 1 into 7 is equal to 7. 2 into 7, 14. 3 into 7, 21 it is. Now 4 into 7 is 28. 5 into 7 is 35. Okay, now 7, 14, 21, 28, 35. So these all are multiples of what? These all are multiples of this number, that is 7. Okay, so these are the multiples of 7. What are the multiples of 7? 7, 14, 21, 28 and 35 are the multiples of 7. Okay. When we multiply a number with 1, 2, 3 and so on, we get multiplication table of that number. Okay. When we multiply a number with 1, 2, 3, we will get. Okay. So here I am multiplying this 7 by 1. Here I am multiplying 7 by 2. Here I am multiplying this 7 by 3 and so on. Okay. So if I multiply any number, that is, for example, I am taking here the number that is 7 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and so on, then we will get the multiplication table of that particular number. So here you can see we are multiplying 7 by 1, next by 2, next by 3, next by 4, next by 5, next by 6, next we are multiplying 7 by 7 and next we are multiplying 7 by 8. So then we are getting the multiplication table of which number? 7 only, because 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21, 7 fours are 28, 7 fives are 35, now 7 sixes are 42, 7 sevens are 49, 7 eights are how much? 56. So if I multiply this 7 by 9, then I will get 63. Now if I multiply 7 by 10, then I will get 70. So this is nothing but the multiplication table of which number? 7. Okay. If I multiply any number by 1, 2, 3 and so on, then we will get the multiplication table of that particular number. Okay. Here we are multiplying 7 by 1, 2, 3 and so on up to 10. Then here we are getting, after multiplication, we are getting the multiplication table of this 7. Okay. Now, mental maths. Circle the multiples of each number. Okay. In that they have given multiples of 8. Okay. Here we are doing the mental maths problems. Okay, in that circle the multiples of each number. Okay, in that the first one is multiples of 8. In that 64, 72, 36, 80, 45. Okay, so they have given like this. Now you have to circle the multiples of 8. Multiples of 8 means, so among, we are having here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, some 5 numbers. So among all these numbers, which number comes in 8th table? That is nothing but the multiple of 8. So let us start reading the 8th table. 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 24 is not here, and 8 threes are, sorry, 8 ones are 8 is not here, 8 twos are 16 is also not here, 8 threes are 24, no, 8 fours are 32, no, 8 fives are 40, no, 8 sixes are 48, no, 8 sevens are 56, no, 8 eights are 64, so here 64 is there, then circle this. Okay, now 8 nines are 72, 72 is also there, so circle this. This is nothing but a multiple of 8. Now 8 eights are, sorry, 8 eights are 64, 8 nines are 72, 8 tens are 80, 80 is there, circle it. But the 36 and 45 does not comes in 8th table, so leave this here. Now 64, 72 and 80 are the multiples of 8. Okay, like this you have to find the multiples of that number. To find the multiples of any number, you have to start reading, you should start reading that table, then you will get the multiples of that particular numbers. Okay, next, multiples of 11. Multiples of 11 we have to find, and in this box they have given some 5 number, that is 77, 54, 32, 10, 66. Now we have to find the multiples of 11. For that, what I will do, I will read the 11th table, that is 11 ones are 11, so check whether 11 is there or not. See here, 11 ones are 11. 11 is there or not? No, 11 is not. Now 11 twos are 22. 22 is also not there. So 11 threes are 33. 33 is also not there here. Now 11 fours are 44. 44 is also not. Now 11 fives are 55. 55 is also not there here. Now 11 sixes are 66. 66 is there. So circle this like this. Now 11 sevens are 77. 77 is there or not? Yes, it is there. So, circle it. Next, this is 110. So, 11 8s are 88. 11 9s are 99. 88 and 99 both are not there here. Now, 11 10s are how much? It is 110. Yes, 110 is present here. So, circle it. Now, 77, 110 and 66 are the multiples of 11 and we have circled them. Okay. Like this. You have to find the multiples of 13, multiples of 12 and multiples of 15. Okay? Now, so do these three problems. So this is 1, multiples of 13, multiples of 12, multiples of 15. Do it in your home. Okay. Now, consider a multiplication fact. 4 into 6 is equal to 24. Can we say that 24 is a multiple of 4? Yes, because 4 times 6 is equal to 24. So, more about multiples. Representing this in the form of 4 times into 6, which is equal to 24. that's why we can say that 24 is the multiple of 4. Can we say that 24 is multiple of 6? Yes, we can say like that, because 6 times 4 times 6 is equal to 24 means we can say that 6 times 4 equal to 24. It means if I write 6 times 4, 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. See here, 1 times, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, 6 times. If I add 6 times 4, then we will get 24. Okay? So I can write this 6 times 4 as I had. I can write this in terms of multiplication as 6 times 4. As in the properties of multiplication only, we have told that multiplication is commutative. Means 2 into 4 is nothing but 4 into 2. You can write, okay, 2 into 4, 4 into 2 is 1 and 7. Because 2 into 4 equal to 8, 4 into 2 equal to 8. The result does not change. Okay, so like this, 4 into 6 is nothing but 6 into 4. The result comes same. So like this. If 24 is there, means 24 is the multiple of 4 as well as 24 is the multiple of 6. We can say like that. Therefore, when we multiply two numbers to find a product, the product is the multiple of both the numbers. Okay. When we multiply two numbers, here multiplying two numbers, 4 into 6. So when we multiply two numbers to find the product, here the two numbers are 4 and 6 and the product is 24. So here what they are explaining? If we multiply two numbers to find the product, then the product is the multiple. This product is the multiple of both the numbers. 24 is the multiple of 4 as well as 24 is the multiple of 6. Okay. Now, so 24 is multiple of both 4 and 6. Let us divide 32 by 7. Let us divide 32 by 7. As 32 is not divisible by 7 and leaves a non-zero remainder, so it is not a multiple of 7. Okay, now let us divide 32 by 7. So we are dividing 32 by 7. Means 7 1s are 7, 7 2s are 14, 7 3s are 21, 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35. We cannot take 35 here because we have to take the number less than or equal to this divided. Here divided is 32. 7 5 is 35, it's become. So we cannot take that one. So I have to take the less one. That is 7 4 is 28 and 18. Now let us subtract 28 from 32. So if you subtract 28 from 32, you will get 4. Okay? 4. 4 is less than 7, but there is no number left in the dividend to take down. So leave the problem here itself. The problem is over. Now here the quotient is 4 and the remainder is also. So after dividing 32 by 7, we are getting the remainder 4, which is non-zero. Non-zero means we have not got the answer 0 here. Okay, the answer is greater than 0 or one number has appeared here. It means 32 is not the multiple of 7. Okay, if any number, if it is a multiple of the given number, then after dividing that particular number by the 7, then we should get the remainder 0. Then only we can say the given, this given product is the multiple of 7. Say for example, here I have told 24 is the multiple of 6. Then in this case, if I divide this 24 by 6, then I have to get the remainder as 0. See here, 6 4 is 24. 24 minus 24 is 0. So here we can say 24 is the, sorry, 6 is the, sorry, what do you say? 24 is the multiple of 6, but here 32 is not the multiple of 7, because how I am telling that 32 is not the multiple of 7 means after dividing this 32 by 7, you are getting the remainder which is non-zero. So that's why 32 is not the multiple of 7. Or roughly you can say the number which does not appear in that particular table. So here 32 is not appears in 32, it does not appear in 7's table, no. So that's why. So this number is not the multiple of 7. Whereas 24 appears in 6 table. 6 4s are 24. So that's why this 24 is known as multiple of 6. Okay. Now, properties of multiples. Okay. Properties. properties of multiples. In the chapter multiplication, we have learned the properties of multiplication. But here, we are going to learn the properties of multiplication. Okay, multiples and multiplication, the two terms are different. Okay, don't misunderstand that both are one and the same. So there it is multiplication, but here multiples. Okay, in that the first property tells every number is a multiple of 1. For example, 1 into 4 is equal to 4, 1 into 12 is equal to 2, and so on. Okay, so the first property of multiples, what it is telling? So every number is the multiple of 1. Yes, this is the correct one. Properties of multiples. In that, the first property tells every number is the multiple of 1. Means if you multiply any number by 1, then whatever the product you will get, so that number will be the multiple of 1. For example, what they have given here, 1 into 4. 1 into 4 is equal to 4, 1 into 12 is equal to 12. So here 4 is the multiple of 1, 12 is the multiple of 1. If I write 1 into 7, so I will get 7. 7 is the multiple of 1. And if I write 1 into 15, I will get 15. Here 15 is the multiple of 1. So like this, you can take any number. Every number is the multiple of 1. Okay. If you multiply any number by 1, so whatever the result you will get, that result or the product will be the multiple of 1. Okay. So this is the first property of multiple. Now, come to second one. Every number is multiple of itself. For example, 1 into 3 is equal to 3. And 1 into 15 is equal to 15. Every number is a multiple of itself. For example, they have given 1 into 3. So here, I think it is wrong. Here it should be 3 into 3. 3 into 3 is equal to 9. Okay? 15 into 15 is equal to 15. Every number is the multiple of itself. Means if I take 3, itself means 3 is a multiple of itself. Means 3 only. 3 is a 9. So this 9 is the multiple of, every number is multiple of itself. Yes, so it is correct only. 1 into 3 is equal to 3, 1 into 15 is equal to 15. Okay, so here I can say 1 into 3 is equal to 3. 3 is the multiple of 1 as well as 3. No. So here what they are telling, every number is the multiple of itself, means 3 is there. Okay, 3 is the multiple of 3. Here also 15 is the multiple of 15, or you can say 15 is the multiple of 1 as well as 15 is the multiple of 15. But we are leaving that 15 is the multiple of 1. Here we are interested only with 15 is the multiple of 15, 3 is the multiple of 3. You can take any number. If I take 1 into 5, I will get 5. 5 is the multiple of 5. Here, every number means here 5. This 5 is the multiple of itself. 5 is the multiple of 5. Like this. Okay. So, this is the second property. Now, third one is every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to the number itself. For example, the multiple of 4 are 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, and so on. Here, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24 are greater than or equal to 4. So, what is the third property? Every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to the number itself. It means every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to the number itself. For example, 4. Okay. So, the multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 6, 12, 16, 20. So, multiples means you have to write the table. So, whatever the numbers appears in that table, so those are nothing but the multiples of that particular number. Here, the multiples of 4 are 4 is a 4, 4 is a 8, 4 3 is a 12, 4 is 4 is a 16, 4 5 is a 20. So, every number is the, so the multiples of any number are greater than or equal to this particular number. So, here 20, 24. Okay. You can see here, the first multiple of 4 is 4, second one is 8, third one is 12, and so on. So, the multiples of this 4 are either greater than 4 or equal to 4. But the multiples of this 4 does not be less than 4. Okay. If I take 6, then the multiple of 6 are 6 1 the 6, 6 2 the 12, 6 3 the 18, 6 4 the 24, and so on. So the first multiple of 6 is 6 only. So 6 is equal to, and 12, 18, 24 are greater than 16. It means the multiples of any number will be either greater than or equal to. So here equal to symbol will be applicable only for 6, because 6 is only equal to 6. And rest all the numbers are greater than 6. So this greater or for this remaining number, and this equal to symbol is for 6. Okay. So this is about the third property of multiples. Now the fourth one is, every number has unlimited number of multiples. For example, multiples of 8 are 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, 48, 56, 64, and so on. Therefore, there is no largest multiple of a number. Okay? Every number has unlimited number of multiples. Okay. For example, every number has unlimited number of multiples. Means if I find the multiples of 8, so let us write the 8 table. 8 1 is 8, 8 2 is 16, 8 3 is 24, 8 4 is 32, 8 5 is 40, 8 6 is 48, 8 7 is 56, 8 8 is 64, 8 7 is 72, 8 10 is 80, 8 11 is 88, 8 12 is 96. Okay. 12 are 96 and 8 13 are how much? 8 13 are 104 and so on. 8 13 are 820 is 825 are 800 are 8101 are, like this goes on unlimited. Okay, every number has unlimited number of multiples. But for the tables, we will consider up to 10. 81 are 8, 82 are 16, 83 are 24, and so on. 810 are 80. Okay, you again tables solve no, only 810s are still. ಅನ್ನೇ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಬಟ್ 8 11s ಅನ್ನು ಇರ್ತಾವೆ ಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಇದು ಆಫಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಏನಂತಾರೆ ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಬಟ್ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ 8 11s 8 12s ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರಿಂದ ಅದು ಎಂಡೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅನ್ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಹೇಳಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅನ್ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ 8 ಆರ್ 8 16 24 32 40 48 56 54 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೋ ಆನ್ Therefore, there is no largest multiple of a number. Okay. As unlimited number of multiples is any number. But unlimited is the only count. Count is impossible. So that's why we cannot say the largest multiple of this number. Okay. Largest is the only thing. Largest is the only thing. So that's why we have largest multiple of any number determined. Okay. Like this. So these are the four properties of multiples. In the next class, we will go through finding the multiples. Okay. The next heading is there, no? Finding the multiples. We will learn that in the next class. So for this class, you please write the properties of multiplication 2 times each. Okay. I will give you as a homework. Write. Write properties of multiples 2 times each. So this is the homework for you people. Okay. So this is what it is, the homework. Homework, today's homework is write the properties of multiples. Each property you have to write 2 times. Okay, there are 4 properties. So each property you have to write 2 times and send me in the WhatsApp group. Okay. Thank you.